Hey there everyone, welcome back to my channel once again. Here, this is Mac, and for today's gameplay commentary video once again is Terminator Resistance. So we're focusing on this video here upon at the fairly beginning of things about various types of standard weapons that are pretty much not going to work and which you're going to have to improvise with, and then focus on getting some of the antibiotics for Erin, and then that'll be it for that. And we'll, and beyond that, you know, I'll produce another one to kind of like continue on with the whole video and then finish it off from there. So let's go ahead and get at this. Commander Baron gave an order to attack a Skynet research facility located in the old University Hospital. If they managed to liberate the hospital, her soldiers could still be there. But that's a big if. Okay, so pretty much, you know, the same thing as I had read in the last video. Just waiting for this thing to load up and it's all good here. All right, here we go. Okay, so there's an old university hospital we gotta get to, and Jennifer is around. I don't know if there's anything I would need to pick up exactly per se, but I'll have a look. Oh yeah, actually there would be. There we go. Okay. That should be good. Trying to see if there's any more other ones like that. Yeah, there we go. This is the reason why you would have to pardon me. This is the reason why you have to do like a very thorough search around, because there could be some items that you can be able to grab and either sell them off or trade them. And take a look at this. An old computer like that. Guarantee it, that looks like something from, like, what? 90s? Perhaps early 2000s? Give or take? Well, apparently, that the whole part of Judgment Day happened sometime around 1997, I think. So I'm pretty sure that's the reason why we have that kind of, like, old tech right there. So I pretty much got what I needed. Okay, so that section has been pretty much been cleared out. Wow, like I said, this is, yeah, I know I've said this plenty of times, but pretty damn well sad and depressing. And to think, apparently, this type of war against the machines has been raging on for about, according to what I've had read once or heard, this type of war between man and machine has been raging on for about, I'm thinking 30 years or something like that. I think that's a long damn time just to fight between man and machine. Even other world wars like World War I and II, they never had gone for that long, but 30 years, that's holy good God. That's all I gotta say. Anyway. Oh yeah, Jacob's cutie right over there.
Don't sneak up on me like that.
Okay, in that case, would this work?
It's bad enough with those creepy noises.
What noises?
Every once in a while, there's this unbearable scream coming from that hospital. We need to see what's going on. Let's move. Let me. Picking locks is kind of my thing.
I could do the same thing there, sweetheart.
Voila. Jeez. Looks like a silverfish got him. They're every scavenger's nightmare. Ooh, look. This poor guy is still holding a sound decoy.
Sound decoy?
You resistance guys just shoot at everything that moves, don't you? Silverfish are sensitive to noise. So, before it pops up from the ground and starts chasing, you throw a sound decoy. It'll draw any nearby silverfish away. I guess you can take it. He won't be needing it anyway. Did you hear that? That's a sound I was talking about.
I don't think you should go any further.
And what about you?
I have to go. That could be the resistance.
I understand. I feel stupid asking you this, but Erin wanted me to find some antibiotics for Mark. I know I'm not making it easy on you, but if you're in there and you find some, we would really appreciate it.
I'll see what I can do.
And remember that your gun won't do you any good against Terminators. So when you see one, do what I do. Sneak past them. I'll be waiting for you at the hideout. Take care.
Okay, so now, before we do go any further, any further down this path here, and beyond that point, you will be hearing, the future Jacob slash Stranger on the radio, and all of you who have played this before, I'm pretty sure you know how this goes. Now, before we go down there, let's pick up this. Okay. Pretty much what this is you take this item, activate it, makes a very loud kind of noise, you toss it, and then any type of silverfish or terminating machine, lower grade kind of thing, they'll hear it, they'll get drawn right to it, and it's pretty much like a diversion type of a device. Okay, and on top of that, there's also another thing that which Jennifer just said about roughly a minute or two ago, which was this.
And remember that your gun won't do you any good against Terminators. So when you see one, do what I do. Sneak past them. I'll be waiting for you at the hideout. Take care.
And yes, she would be right. The weapons that Jacob currently has right now, give an example, anywhere between like a simple handgun, submachine gun, automatic rifle, shotgun, against more upgraded type of Terminator machines like the T-800s and up will literally do shit. And what I mean by that, good example of that. One more second here. Okay, so just to quickly kind of give off an example here. Okay, there we go. So, here's a whole circle of the type of weapons we have. Handgun, Uzi millimeter, automatic rifle, shotgun. Now, when it is up against, like, Terminator machines like T-800s and up, well, I don't know if there's going to be any T-600s, but I'm pretty confidently sure there won't be. And those are the type of Terminator machines with rubber skin, or rather rubber faces. But with T-800 Terminator machines, and especially the ones with without any type of living tissue skin, yeah, evidently you're shit out of luck with that one. Now, just to give off a good example of that, so in other words, if by some chance John Connor from the movie Terminator Salvation fires a shitload of rounds from a handgun, such as what's highlighted right there, he fires off, you know, a bunch of rounds from a handgun against a T-800 Terminator machine. If he fires off a bunch of rounds from a handgun at a Terminator machine, such as in this scene here from Terminator Salvation. If John Connor or any, you know, resistant soldier member within the whole TechCom forces, or, you know, within the whole human resistance in general, if they cannot take down a T-800 Terminator machine with a simple handgun, as, you know, like obviously as it was already demonstrated from Terminator Salvation, then on this game here, that's going to mean. Just like the movie, on this game here, that's not going to do you any good. Obviously, that's not going to help whatsoever. Same thing with the Uzi Millimeter, a submachine gun. Same thing. As you can already see and already tell from that clip I just finished showing you, plain simple as it is, won't do you any good, not gonna help. Up against humans? Well, obviously that's a given. Up against war-raging type of warfare machines? Yeah, good luck with that. And, 1 second here, there we go. And, you know that one type of automatic rifle that John Connor was using up against that same T-800 Terminator machine, although that same machine was surrounded by living tissue, which looked like a human being, pretty much the same thing as the whole illusion of Arnold, such as in this scene right here in Terminator Salvation. Once again, that's going to imply if Christian Bale's John Connor could not take down a T-800 Terminator machine through any type of automatic rifle such as that, if he couldn't take one down through the movies, that's also once again going to imply. That type of automatic rifle won't do a damn thing for you on this game here. Now, however, with this type of weapon, you'll have a very, very, very type of miner chance of, you know, taking down one of those T-100 Terminator machines, but it's only going to help you a little bit. Not a whole lot, just a very, very minor. Such as, good example of that, this shotgun here, I don't know if that's a 12-gauge shotgun, probably is, but anyways, this shotgun right here, a good example of that, from the first Terminator film, when the three actors, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Michael Biehn, and Linda Hamilton, they're in that one scene at that one club, when Arnold's character, the T-800, was like literally seconds or microseconds away from gunning down Linda Hamilton's character, Sarah Connor, and just as it was about to do that, then that's when Michael Biehn's character, Kyle Reese, comes swiftly right on out, right behind the machine, and takes down the machine with a shotgun from this scene right here, again, from the first Terminator film. So, if the character Kyle Reese can take down a Terminator machine with a shotgun, just like in that scene from the first Terminator film, then yes, that's going to mean that you can... Do the same thing on this game here, but as you already had witnessed through that clip I just finished showing you here, you can take down a T-800 Terminator machine with a shotgun, no problem, but the only minor helpful effect with it, like a minor type of upper hand with it, is you can take down a T-800 for about anywhere between a fraction of a second to maybe a full second. I know it minorly only helps, like very minorly, but unfortunately, like, look at it this way. Until you do upgrade and get better weapons, which inevitably that you will, guaranteed for sure you will, until that happens, for now, that's the only thing you've got. That's the only thing you have. And, well, yeah, the shotgun will be able to take one of them down, only for a second, but once you take that Terminator down, like that T-800, just for a second, you take it down, well, the only thing I can recommend is you haul ass and get the hell out of there and try and run for cover or hide somewhere so that T-800 machine doesn't come looking for you. Provided if it doesn't have infrared and say, hey, what is that? Oh, that's not one of our machines. That's actually a human being, and then you're pretty much done for right there. Another thing, especially on this level, the only thing you've got to maybe destroying one of those Terminator machines, considering the fact that you don't have an upgraded type of high-tech type of plasma rifle or whatever, is this pipe grenade. that can help you out. Like, take about, roughly about, maybe like one or two out. But you're wasting about anywhere between four or more pipe grenades just to take a few of them out. Like, if you were to take one of those T-800 Terminator machines out, it probably takes about roughly two of those just to take one of them out. Keep in mind that you get upgraded points, and then you can be able to take one of them out with just one of those. But at this point in time right now, it's not that high. You can maybe take one of the T-800 Terminator machines out with like two of those, a few of them. Obviously it's going to take more. So at this point in time, that's the only thing you've got. A very interesting thing what happened was that as I was trying to do some type of gameplay filming, just trying to collect some examples here, I don't know if this was a glitch or not, I don't know, but I did manage to take one of those T-100 Terminator machines out with a shotgun, and very strangely enough, this happened. Yeah, I know, very surprisingly enough. Like, it was quite helpful yet strange. It's, you know, it like took that one type of that one Terminator machine down with a shotgun, and then just as it was getting up, boom, it just vanished, disappeared, or exploded or something. It's like, that was kind of strange. Yeah, that one Terminator, it happened, but with the rest of them that I had, that I was doing the same thing just to kind of get that example, nope. It didn't happen with the rest of them. They just after about one or two shots, they all fall down, they all stay down for like very briefly for a second, and they come back up, and then they keep on going, trying to shoot you. You shoot them again, and then they very swiftly go down, and they very, very swiftly come back up again. So it's like they stay down for like anywhere between a fraction of a second or a second. Again, it doesn't take long. They don't take long to stay down. Then they come back up, and they go at you again. I thought that was kind of comical yet strange. But for the most part, you take a shotgun, boom, boom, and then they go down for only like a second, and they come back up again. And like, you can't kill them. You can knock them down, but you can't kill them. Just like in that one scene. From the first Terminator film. So again, unfortunately, that's the only thing I got. But for the most part, like Jennifer said, you will have to sneak around. And don't get me wrong, there's a way you can do it. So anyways, let's go ahead and go at this. Okay. Now you're well on your way, and in about a second or so, you'll end up hearing Jacob the Stranger. In other words, you the player.
I see you're back on your feet.
You?
I left you a hacking device. It's in the basement of a building off the main street. It will help you get inside that hospital.
Right now, you need to start answering some questions.
There will be a time for that, but right now, you need to help the people inside. As for Colin, there was nothing I could have done. It was either him or you. And it couldn't have been you.
Hello?
Well, technically he is right. Jacob has to remain alive. Keep in mind, I did mention has to, as in he needs to remain alive. Yeah, I'm putting a lot of emphasis upon that, but I have a reason for that. Don't worry, I got a few more. There we go. Mm-hmm. should be all right. Hopefully there's nothing else that I'm missing. And I hope it's not. Okay. Should be all right. I was also just kind of thinking to myself here while I was, playing this game here. Considering the fact there's a lot of properties that are wrecked, commonly, if there was some kind of explosion that would happen, you know, prior to the world ending, or even if the world wasn't ending at all, and some of these buildings were, you know, already destroyed, or some kind of property damage or something like that, usually it would take like some kind of restoration company to restore that, and it would take a good deal amount of tax money just to pay the workers just to get it all cleaned up. Yet since all this happened and there is no, you know, there is no governments at all, there's no businesses of any kind, and even after Skynet gets taken down, there's going to be a great deal amount of people volunteering just to get all of this replaced and repaired. And I'm pretty sure the whole part of paying taxes just to get everything all fixed up or whatever, I'm pretty sure that's not going to really matter. Just something I was kind of thinking about for the hell of things. Like, yeah, actually, that kind of would make more sense in depth anyways. Like, it's not, no one's gonna really pay attention to that. This section should be good now. Oh yeah, no, I was already through there, never mind. Okay. Now before I do that, bag full of goodies, and I'm pretty confidently sure that deceased corpse is not gonna really be needing it. Excellent. I was hoping to throw it a little further, like, instead of at that location, but just like a little bit up ways towards over here. So, not only will that one be taken out, but top of that, that one will be taken out as well. Well, at least I was hoping. Is what I was looking for. You do end up using these type of sound devices, but in my own perspective, I don't really think all that much. It's like very little do you even use something like that. Let's see about if I can. I'm just gonna quickly check something here. Nope, I guess not. I don't know if I could do this or not, but we'll see. And yes, you can also take him out that way, but it does take timing and the proper angle to do it. And it looks like Skynet is... Oh, shit. Those damn aerial drones. Trading goods. Okay, here we go. You can reach some of these through that little section right there, but I wanted to try and be able to, sorry, one second here. I wanted to try and be able to, like, come in here instead and just grab them, like, naturally. Back here. And a computer hacking device. Yep, that's gonna be very nice and beneficial. And see? Oh, if you can see very faintly, yeah, armored spider. This is your hacking device right there.
This is it.
Yes, yes it is. All right, here we go. There we go. Now, this section is good and cleared. You know, I know I have said this already a few times, but my god, it must really suck just living in a world like this on a daily basis. I know it's only merely fictionalized, but it's almost like, wow, you gotta really feel sorry for these people. Well, I guess 2 out of 3 ain't bad. And just about ready to gain a level. Well, like I mentioned, not exactly sneak from the Metal Gear Solid games, but you will be doing a great deal amount of sneaking around. I think someone's skin's about being torn off, so Skynet can analyze it. I might be wrong, but who knows? Now their armor's upgraded. We can just get a little close. Great, which means I may have to sacrifice one of those damn pipe bombs. Not overly thrilled about it, but whatever. It's done. And gained a nice little point out of it too, which is pretty sweet. Huh? Is there anything down here? Oh. Just another little pathway. Okay. Now there is another section over here. Sleeping here, trying to gain some shelter. And another hero as well, trying to gain some shelter so they can try and stay warm. I'm sorry, this is funny. Fuck, 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 fuck. Where the fuck did they all come from? If I don't get Frank some adrenaline, he is not going to make it through the night. But there are so many of them. What the fuck should I do? This would be easier if I at least had a shotgun. Okay, I know some people don't really care about this, but to those that are kind of watching this, my apologies for the excessive amount of the whole little F-bombs, but I'm sorry, this was just way too funny. That was just too hilarious. I'm sorry, but that was. Okay, so just gotta get myself back. That should be about right, and angle this right. Excellent. Jeez. Like I said, they have to find what they need just to even try and make it through another day. Is this a clinic or something? Huh, maybe. Or a laundromat. Oh, whatever. Wait a second here, hold on. How is it that... Okay, I see a mattress right there. Someone was clearly sleeping there. Yet how is that possible if this wall here was boarded up, was already bricked and boarded up and whatever, and so was this? Maybe someone was probably like quite skinny enough they can be able to get through all this. But it still doesn't make any sense though. Whatever. Trying to look at the sign, couldn't see anything, so whatever. No, couldn't see that either. Alright. So, now what I'm thinking about here is that if you can't try and memorize this part of the area, this whole area after the whole aftermath is going to be swarming with Terminator machines, the T-800s. And I'm thinking this pile of rock and this burnt up car or whatever is still going to be here or not, I'm not sure. Probably. It's hard to say. But I do know that I'll be making my way pretty much from this section all the way down over here and making my way all the way up towards over here and out towards that direction over there. It'll fit all in.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever you think you might be able to take out one, out comes the other. Always seems to happen that way. Okay, so I'm going to switch out that... Well, whatever. Excellent. Wonderful. So keep in mind, this surrounding area from here all the way across to over here is going to be swarming with Terminator machines. Including, inevitably, there's going to be like a good army of those machines marching down, like pretty much like right across from over here, and making their way down to straight down that way. And meanwhile, what I'll have to do, inevitably, is once I come up this way, I see an HK flying by, and I'll have to tuck myself over here and crouch over here. So a good fleet of those guys keep on going this way and down that way, and that's gonna mean I'll have to stealth my way out towards that direction. Later on, you'll see.
Wonder if I could control those turrets with the hacking device.
Yes, you can. Absolutely, you can. I've done this before plenty of times. Excellent. Hacked to one of these damn things, and now it's on my side. Excellent, nicely done. You know something, funny little story with that is, it was over here. I do recall one time I made a bit of one of those ridiculous mistakes, and as soon as I came out of, where's that door? I came out of this door right here, and once you do leave this whole area, you'll be coming out of this door and hauling it way up there. Once I came out of that door, I discovered that there are a whole bunch of Terminator machines that are going to be marching down this way, and, well, you know, when you're new at this game, you don't know what to expect. I immediately hid myself behind this vehicle right here, and hoping the hell that, you know, they won't be able to find me, but as soon as they all marched down here and began swarming around here very close to me, I realized, damn, I just screwed up, and now there's no way in hell I'm getting out of this. So, and well, I had to restart the whole part of that section. Okay, here we go. Okay, here we go. Thank you. I thought I was gonna lose that one for a second. Or so I thought. Oh shit. Damn it. Here we go. There is a certain quote in this one television series which got turned into a movie, which was The A-Team, which is, "Gotta love it when a plan comes together." Okay, is there anything missing here? I hope not. Then again, who knows? Jeez, this is gonna be one of those tricky ones. I hate this. That was quite suspenseful, I'm not gonna lie. So like I mentioned in about a few videos back, yeah, this thing's really smoking up. Anyways, like I mentioned in a few videos back, if you had a hacking device, you can very easily hack one of these and use it towards your advantage. Just like I just did. It can be a bit tricky, especially by the timing. Well, okay. Yep, you see that? Bodies. I'm pretty confidently sure Those are not T-800s in there. And just going to finish off the video right here, as I mentioned. Well, everyone, that's pretty much it for this one here, and I'll get another one produced up as soon as I can in order to pretty much free those soldiers and finish off the level from there so we can kind of press onward. So, once again, everyone, I hope you enjoyed this video here once again. This is Mac. Please be sure to subscribe, give this video a nice little like, and if you have any comments or questions in relation to this, by all means, go ahead and throw in the comment section. Once again, your support has always been greatly appreciated. Thank you very kindly, and see you on the next round.